What do interaction maps allow you to do and what do you visualize? So full interaction maps allows you to indeed map the interaction preferences around molecules in a crystal structures. So you have a three-dimensional map of probability for the interactions. So this means that you can look at the contacts, like the hydrogen bonds, as we see here, or short contacts, and rationalize them against where you would expect to find interaction for such molecule. And full interaction maps also allow you to identify hotspots for interactions around chemical groups. And as a bonus, you can make some very pretty images of where you expect to find interactions for your molecule. So we said that we're visualizing a 3D maps of where we would expect interactions, but what does this mean? So we have here, we have represented in blue, where areas where we would expect to find hydrogen bond donors. Then in red, we have areas where we would expect to find hydrogen bond acceptors. And in orange, areas where we would expect to find hydrophobic interactions, such as aromatic or CH groups. So you see that here we have already turned on the hydrogen bonds, and we observe that these hydrogen bonds are falling exactly where we would expect the interaction to be, thanks to the prediction of the full interaction maps, except this one here, which instead is outside the area. So the question would be, what does this mean for the stability of the structure? So before moving on to how we generate these full interaction maps from Mercury, we want to see what happens behind the scenes. So where do the maps come from and how do we derive them? So full interaction maps are built from the data that is in the CSD. So we can mine the CSD to find different interactions and learn from them. So if we think, as an example, this central group, the CONH2 here, and we consider the interaction of this central group with this contact group NH. So we can see, for example, how the geometry of this interaction is in this structure. We can then consider another structure, for example, this one. And you can see that the geometry is different. So we can then overlap the representation and see them together. And we can see the two geometries represented here. So the CSD has over 1.1 million structures available, as we heard before. So you can repeat this operation, and I say you can, but this is done behind the scenes, so you don't need to worry to do that. So you can mine the CSD and find these interactions. So you would get something more or less like this. So we can see the different geometries in the CSD for this interaction. So we can turn then this plot into a contour plot to see where the areas where we would most expect the might to be with respect to the carbonyl R. Interestingly, we notice that the two areas with higher density are at the side of the carbonyl, and this is exactly what we would expect by chemical intuition, because we know that this oxygen here has two lone pairs, and so it's quite beautiful to see how something that we know is backed up by data in the CSD, but also that it is following exactly what we would expect to do. As I said, this is done behind the scenes, and there is another application, another software from the CSD, which is called IsoStar, that creates these maps for the contact groups interactions. So moving on to FIMs, so how do we actually then obtain a full interaction mass rate? So what happens is that the molecule is broken down into fragments, and then the IsoStar maps for each fragment are then recombined together to give the full interaction map. So if we consider an example, so for example, this molecule, and we want to study again the interaction with the NH group, as we saw before. So what happens? We break it down into fragments, which are represented by Bollen sticks as examples on these representations. And we can see that for each group, we have generated the full interaction maps for the interaction with the NH group. And this is the group that we saw before, for example. So what happens next is that we can recombine them and obtain a fuller full interaction map, so considering the whole molecule. You can also consider different probes. So we consider the NH, but you will see there are more available. So you will have a map as the one that we saw before. This is an example of the use of full interaction maps for an early development candidate for a drug. And you can see that it has two polymorphs, polymorph A, which is a metastable form, and polymorph B, which is the stable form. So we can use full interaction maps to think about the intermolecular interaction geometries and what they could mean in terms of solid state stabilities. So what we can see here in terms of full interaction maps is that the packing arrangement of the stable polymorph form B satisfied the full interaction maps particularly well, while arrangement A doesn't. So this could be an insight in the solid form stability. So how do we create a full interaction map then? As we said, everything that I said so far happened behind the scenes. So creating FIMs for Mercury, it's really a click of a button. So you go to the CSD Materials menu, you select full interaction maps, you have the menu appearing with all the probes available and the colors that were used in the representation. There are three selected by default, the uncharged NH nitrogen, the carbonyl oxygen, and the aromatic CH carbon, but you can select what applies the best to your structure. You click calculate maps and you have the full interaction map for your structure. So it's really a couple of clicks. And you can read more and find more in our blog. As I mentioned before, you can also represent the hotspots, so the position of highest local density for each contour surface. And you can do this by ticking hotspot before clicking calculate maps. And you will get a representation kind of like this. If it is too crowded and you cannot really see the hotspot, you can go then to the maps tab of your full interaction map window and untick all. So you will not see all the full interaction maps, but only the hotspots.
So this is crizotinib. Now, this is a molecule that we're going to come back to in a little while. First of all, what I want to show you is my hydrogen bonds definition, where I've made sure that I only want a hydrogen atom to be present on my molecule. Everything else I've set is the default though. And so if I turn that on, I can see the hanging contacts that I've made for this particular structure. So that's fine. I'm going to turn those off now, because full interaction maps will be generated for everything that you have on the in the visualizer, unless you select otherwise. So that means that if I kept those hanging contacts on, I'd have generated additional full interaction maps for those, which I don't want to do. So if I go to the CSD Materials menu and select full interaction maps, I get this this menu comes up here. Now, by default, we have three probes selected. We have the uncharged NH nitrogen, the carbonyl oxygen, and the aromatic CH carbon. So these represent a hydrogen bond, a generic hydrogen bond donor, a generic hydrogen bond acceptor, and a generic hydrophobic group. We tend to recommend that for a first pass, you just look at these. Although if you're interested in some other chemistries, you can see there's quite a diversity of different functional groups here. Now to calculate those maps, I click calculate maps and give it a minute to run. And then what you can see is those maps have been generated for me. Now they have different contour levels. The contour levels give you an idea of the number of times more than random you're likely to see an interaction there. So a third contour level of 6 means that interactions here are at least 6 times more likely than random. So in terms of statistics, we're really starting to see a preference for forming interactions at these points here. I can control the levels that I show with these maps from the second tab here. And so by unticking things, I can look at exactly where I want to, if I want to just see my most probable interactions there as well. If I want to generate hotspots on my map and recalculate them, what I'll be able to see once this runs is that if I turn my maps off by unticking everything, I get these little points around my molecule here. And these are the hotspots. These are the areas of highest density for my full interaction maps. I want to turn these back on now. And if I turn on my hydrogen bonding and I start to expand these, you'll be able to see that I form some quite nice hydrogen bonds in this structure. I tend to find that I've got my functional groups appearing where I expect them to appear, although not so much over here. So as you can see, it's very, very easy to generate full interaction maps. And they make really quite striking visuals.
So the first tip is that you can generate a FIM for a portion of a molecule. So to do this, you just need to select the relevant atoms before calculating the map. As a reminder from our Mercury session, there are a number of ways to select atoms or molecules, and these can range from changing the picking mode on the top left, selecting the lasso that you can see there, using the selection menu, or right-clicking in the visualization window. Generating a full interaction map on selected atoms can be really useful if you're interested in exploring just a particular part of a molecule, or if there are multi-molecules or components in the unit cell. The second tip is that you can change the colour of the probe. To do this, you just need to click on the colour listed on the options tab of the full interactions menu. If you click on the colour, it then opens a select colour menu. You can either select a colour or enter the details. If you want to go back to the original colours, then you just hit default. If you've created a useful full interaction map that you want to use later, you can save the map in a number of different formats and ways using the Save Maps, again, on the Options tab of Full Interaction Maps. And here you can see some of the ways that you could save your map. You also have programmatic access to interaction maps through our CSD Python API. So to find out more about this in Mercury, you can go to the CSD Python API menu and click on CSD Python API documentation. Details of how to generate FIMs programmatically can be found in the interaction maps section.